Hi guys, this is GIS and Remote Sensing Basic YouTube channel. If you're newly watching this channel, subscribe it for further videos. Okay, today in this video, we go to see one of my recent publication in Journal of South American Earth Sciences. Okay, see, this is the title, Decadal Scale Spatio-Temporal Changes in Land Use Land Cover of El Potosi Basin at semi-arid northeast Mexico and evolution of peat fire between 1980 to 2020 CE. CE in the sense common era. The subsurface peat fire is major problem in this study area. So we also focused the peat fire as an important part in this paper. Okay. Let's see. This is the general introduction part. This part is explains how the land use land cover is affected due to climate change and how the drought is affected the land use land cover and the worldwide land use land cover impacts and effects of global warming in the land use land cover. Okay, and see, this is a study area location. The study area is presented at the northeast part of Mexico, El Potosi Basin. These are the some important locations in El Potosi Basin. This study area is chosen because of one of the major drought prone basin in the Mexico, and it is mainly affected by lack of surface water and groundwater due to the over exploitation. So this study area is chosen because of drought. Okay, see, this is the materials and methods part. For this study, we have taken 5 different here Landsat imagery. See, 1980, 1990, 2000, 2010, 2020. These 5 decadal land use land cover analysis was calculated in this study. This 5 different year land use land cover data, which means the Landsat data, we have used for this study. So this Landsat data is collected from Earth Explorer website, USGS. For this study, Landsat 3 and 4 Landsat 3 and 4 multispectral scanner is used for 1980 and 1990, and Landsat 5 thematic mapper was used for 2000 and 2010, and finally the Landsat 8 operational land imager OLI is used for 2020. So using these data, we have interpreted the data for creating the land use land cover maps. Before going to the interpretation, the image enhancement techniques was applied, that is histogram equalization, filtering and principal component analysis for a better interpretation. Okay, this is the interpretation part. We used manual on-screen digitization method for a visual interpretation of land use land cover. We have used RGS software for creating the land use land cover map, and after the interpretation we have identified 8 different land use land cover features in this location, that are buildup land, crab land, forest, land with scrub, land without scrub, peat fire land, temporary fallow land, that means temporarily abandoned cultivated, and permanent fallow land, permanently abandoned cultivated land. that is permanent fallow land. Okay. Now we see what is mean by current fallow land. The current fallow land was now we see how we can identify the current fallow land and permanent fallow land in satellite imagery. The current fallow land was observed as a regular shape, round or square, in the imagery without crops during the current year. That means the imagery taken year. The permanent fallow land, however, was seen as an irregular shape without crops, out of cultivation for 1 to 10 years. This is a permanent fallow land. Okay. See, these are all the data we have used for the 5 decadal land use land cover analysis. And these are the spatial resolutions. Landsat 3 is a 60 meter resolution. Landsat 4 to 8 is 30 meter resolution. And this is the data for acquisition of imagery. Okay. Next, the result and discussion part. This part is explains how much of area covered by every land use features by every years. See, this is up to 1980 CE. How the land use features covered and how much of area it is occupied. Likewise, 1980 to 1990 CE, 1992 to 2000 CE. And see, this is the sum of the. And see, this is some field photographs in the study area. Okay, let's see the maps. See, there are 5 different decadal maps are there. The first one, A, is the 1980 land use land cover. B is the 1990 land use land cover. C is the 2000 land use land cover. D is the 2010 land use cover. And E is the 2020, the recent land use land cover. In this map, we see the red tonal areas. See, here and here, these are the areas are built up land, and green color is light green is indicated crop land, yellow is temporary fallow, and shaded lines are permanent fallow, and dark green is the forest area. And this light green is land with scrub, and this sandal color indicates the land without scrub, and this violet color is indicate peat fire land. See, in this map, the land use land cover features are changed every year. So in 1980 there is only a small part of permanent fallow land is there, but it is increased in 2020 and it is covered most of the study area. Okay, this maps are prepared using on-screen digitization using Landsat imagery by creating false color composite and true color composite with image enhancement techniques. I have posted so many videos of how image enhancement techniques applied in satellite imagery and how the visual interpretation works in RGS. So please find this video in my channel. So that was helpful for doing this land use land cover analysis. So now see the changes of features. Land use land cover features every year. See, this is the 1980 land area for every land use features, and this is the 1990 land area, and this is the 2000, and this is the 2010, and this is the 2020. And in mid, see, this is the changes between 1980 to 1990, and this is 1990 to 2000 changes. This is 2000 to 2020 changes, and this is 2010 to 2020 changes, and this is the total changes from 1980 to 2020. See, the built-up area is covered 1.6 square kilometer in 1980, but it is increased in 9.1 in 2020. Likewise, the build-up other land use features also increased every year, and some of the crop land and temporary fallow land is decreased. See, in 1980 the crop land is covered 90 square kilometer, but it is decreased as 15.7 square kilometer in 2020. But see, the major changes and the major impact, one of major impact is peat fire land. In 1980 there is no peat fire area in this study area, so it is 0 square kilometer, but it is increased 17.4 square kilometer in 2020. This is the major changes in this study area. Okay, this is explained in this part. And we can also focus on spatial changes in land use land cover. It means how the build up land is increased from other land. See, the build up land is increased fivefold over the last 4 decades, which is increased from 4.7 square kilometer in agriculture land, 2 square kilometer from land with scrub, around 0.6 square kilometer from land without scrub. Likewise, all the features are explained how it is increased, how it and how it is lost the land to some other land. So this is the same part. And we have separate para for peat fire land, how it is changed and how it is gained the land from another land. This is explained in this part. And see, this is the map for land use land cover changes from one land to another land. Now I will explain this map. See, this map explains how the agriculture land, that means crop land and temporary fallow land. The agriculture land is crop land plus temporary fallow land. So see, the yellow color and green color area is the agriculture land in 1980, but it is decreased. See, the only green color area is in a recent the agriculture land in a recent time. So the agriculture land is decreased like this. And same way we can see the build up land. See, only this green small part of green area is covered as a build up land in 1980 CA, but it is a expansion. The expansion is happened in 2020, from 1980 to 2020. So see the expansion, how it is increased from 1980 to 2020. The forest is decreased. So the 1980, this much of forest area is covered in this study area, but it is decreased as very low part. It is decreased from here to here. See, this is the changes. And the same land with scrub, 1980 most of the area is covered by a land with scrub, but it is decreased in 2020 as very small part. Land without scrub is increasing land use feature. It is covered a very small part in 1980, but see, so many area is covered by land without scrub in a recent time. and permanent fallow land. See, a small area is covered by permanent fallow land in 1980, but it is increased as most of the study area in 2020. This is how the transformation analysis is works on land use land cover changes. Okay, now see the transformation matrix. It means the same concept in a tableized method. See how the land use features are converted from one land use feature to another land use feature. See, this is the build-up area. The build-up area is maintained as build-up land as 1.6 square kilometer. It is increased 4.7 square kilometer from agriculture land and 2 square kilometer from land with scrub and 0.6 square kilometer in land without scrub. And this build-up land lost some land. That means 0.2 square kilometer to peat fire land. So the same way the agriculture land is lost minus 4.7 square kilometer for build up area, and agriculture land is maintained as agriculture land as 60 square kilometer, and it is gained 3 square kilometer from forest area, and it is lost minus 5 square kilometer to land with scrub, and it is lost minus 37 square kilometer to land without scrub. Likewise, the changes of land use features is explained in this table. Okay, now see the peat fire changes. The land with scrub is lost 3.3 square kilometer of land to peat fire land from 1980 to 1990, and again it is lost 3.5 square kilometer of area from 1990 to 2000, and again it is lost 0.6 square kilometer from 2000 to 2010. So total loss of peat fire land from land with scrub is 7.4. likewise, all the features are explained here how it is lost the land to the peat fire land. See, this is the total peat fire land. It is around 17 square kilometer. Okay, see, in this map we can easily understand how the peat fire is increased every year. See, the A map is 1980 to 1990, the B one is 1990 to 2000, C is 2000 to 2010, and D is 2010 to 2020. See this map. In 1980 to 1990, only land with scrub and agriculture land and a small part of the study area is converted as peat fire land. In 1990 to 2000, it is increased. See, the land with scrub, the area is so much of land with scrub area is converted as peat fire land. And already we have some peat fire land from 1980 to 1990 year. So the land peat fire is increased compared to 1980 to 1990. And the same way, see 2000 to 2010, how it is increased, and how it is increased from some other land. It is increased from land with scrub, land without scrub, agriculture land, and a small part of build-up land. See, in 2020, the area of peat fire land is increased very large part of the study area. It's around 17 square kilometer, and it is increased from land without scrub, agriculture land, and permanent fallow land. This is how the peat fire is increased from one year to another year. This is the way of mapping the land use land cover changes. Thank you for watching this channel. Subscribe and share this video.